I'm Lima Milan, and in this video, we're going to look at the creative use of Ableton Live's random device. So the random device is a MIDI processor, so it takes incoming MIDI notes and then can randomize them. So it's the pitch of the note that it will change. So I have a simple offbeat melody pattern running alongside some other instrumental parts. So let's have a quick listen to that. And if I grab the random device and place it on here, before I press play, let me just give you an idea as to why we might want to do this. So randomization is often quite useful for either just creating subtle differences in something or letting it run its course and capturing it so we can edit out some happy accidents that happen from the process of giving it some randomization. So this is quite a simple pattern so we can get used to the actual parameters and what they're technically doing. So the note that's playing the offbeat at the moment is the root note of the song. So the first control we have is this chance dial. So that's basically how likely it is from one note being played to the next through the device that it will randomize it. So to set this up, we're going to go for a 100% chance. Every note that goes in will be randomized. The next option we have is how many notes is it allowed to choose when it's randomizing. So if you stay with just one note, we press play. Is just moving to one alternate note on here. So the way that it works is it's allowed to have one other note in terms of randomization. If you put it halfway through actually on chance, it technically allows you to have two notes because it allows you to have one note step up from the original note, and then it allows a chance to be for the original note to play through two, so we actually have a semitone difference. So let's just play that with a chance around about halfway through. Now the direction of the randomization can be chosen here. So at the moment, it's going up a semitone every time it does the randomization, but we can choose that it goes in a subtractive rather than an additive way. So the note number or the note name that goes in can now go down, in this case, a semitone. Or we can have an alternating version of this, so a combination of both add and subtract by going to the bi-directional mode. Okay, so we're still allowing it to have one other note to happen, but it's flip-flopping between which direction that a note is allowed to travel to. So the actual distance of the note could be controlled by the scale control. So let's go for additive only, so it's going to make the note go up if it randomizes. Let's allow it to have two notes, and then let's choose that it's going to be six notes above. So it should go from the root note that it's on, then it will go to a flat fifth, and then it'll go to the octave above. Or we can set it to one again and it'll just travel to the six semitones above the original root note. Yep, so that's the flat fifth I was talking about. I was just clarifying that on the keyboard. So the final aspect of what we can go for is at the moment, it's in a random mode. So it's more obvious if we go for a larger number of available notes and maybe keep the actual distance of the notes smaller. If we go for the random option, if it's got a choice of three notes, it's not going to go for any one in particular order, it is randomized. So in that response, we don't know what's going to happen, it's completely random, but we can make it do an alternating thing, so it will actually cycle around the available notes and do what we call a round robin, where it goes from the first random choice of note to the next one, to the next one, to the next one, and cycles back around once it's been through the amount of choices that it's been allowed to have. So I just increased the chance then to make it 100% that every time a note was played, a note would be randomized, and now it's cycling around the choice of three different notes that it can move between. So that's all the parameters covered. Let's have a look at the creative context. So with exactly the same sound and the same context of instrumentation, we can just go for a running pattern now and get a bit more into a sort of a techno kind of feel of an analog sequencer where the pitches are just cycling round, and not necessarily cycling round in a way that's technically melodic. It becomes very percussive. So we can take that a little bit further and apply that to something that might be more percussive in nature. So if I just go for the drum section, open up the drum hits, and just load in a conga sample to a track here. And we can set up another MIDI effects track. In fact, let's just step that's just gone into it being an audio sample. So it's just loading a sampler for a minute. Have that conga loaded into there. And let's give that a randomizer again. And give it that 16th pattern. So we're set to randomize, so nothing's going to be the same, or at least it's unlikely it's going to be the same from one bar to the next. But we can set up a MIDI track and start capturing that. So go to Insert MIDI Track, set it to listen to the conga track. We want it to be post effects because we want to record the output of the random device. And then set it to record, and just capture that for a while. And when we know we've heard something that was good within the body of many randomized events, we can then go back and edit that out afterwards. Okay, so we go back to the original. Let's say we've got something that we want there. So get rid of the actual processing aspect of the MIDI and replace our clip that we were feeding into the device with the one that's now been recorded from the device. And then we can go in there and we can start looping a particular section that we think we like. I think that would probably be a good looping point. Yeah, it's got a nice combination of very high frantic parts and then a couple of lower parts that give it actually a slower groove than the 16ths actually would dictate if they were all running at the same pitch. In this video, we've looked at some creative applications of Ableton Live's random MIDI device. We've looked at all the parameters and what they actually can do in terms of what we can control in terms of the randomization. And then we looked at a few creative applications of how we can use it for melodic parts and also some percussive ideas.